Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video we'll be solving a problem based on Monte Carlo simulation and simulation modeling. So Monte Carlo simulation is basically used for static distributions or static probability distributions, and so mainly we'll be concerned regarding the probabilities that we would be requiring to solve this problem. So let's have a look of how to solve this Monte Carlo simulation in computer simulation and modeling. So let's get started. So here is a big problem that's given. So it says that Strong is a dentist who schedules all her patients. So Strong is name of a lady dentist who schedules all her patients for 30 minutes appointments. Some of the patients take more or less than 30 minutes depending on the type of dental work to be done. The following summary shows the various categories of work, their probabilities and the time actually needed to complete the work. Now you have to simulate the dentist clinic for 4 hours and find out the average waiting time for the patients as well as the idleness of the doctor. That is, the doctor was idle for how many times or how many minutes. Assume that all the patients show up at the clinic at exactly their scheduled arrival time starting at 8 a.m. Use the following random number for handling the above problem. That is, they have given a set of some 8 random numbers they have given. So this is the table they have given. So in this problem you might be given the probability values, or in most of the cases they will give you the probability values, but to calculate or to show you how to calculate the probability, I just took this problem. So they have given the category. So there are around 5 categories of filling, crown, cleaning, extracting and cleanup, and the time required for each patient like 45 minutes, 60, 15 and some random times are given, and the number of patients for each of this category have been given, and you have to fill this probability. In most of the cases probability column might have given, like in the table first they have given you the probability, but in this they have not given the probability, so you have to calculate the probability. That's very easy. So first you need to, that's the number of outcomes upon total outcomes. So probability is given by that formula, and so you just add it. So the summation of this, that is 40, 15, that is 55, 70, 80 and 100. So this comes out to be 100. And so the probability for this is, the number of patients for filling is 40. And so you write 40 divided by 100, and so you get 0.4. Similarly, out of 15, this will be 15 out of 100, that is 0.15 patients for crown, and similarly this, and 0.1 and 0.20. Yeah. So this is how the probability is calculated. That's very easy. So it's like you do, that is the number of n of s, n of a upon n of s. So like the number of outcomes divided by the total possible values, or total number of people or total patients in this. Now there is a particular step for calculating this, or for in Monte Carlo simulation you have 4 different steps. So very first is establishing the probability distribution. So that we have done. If it's given, then you need not consider the very first step. Then you need to calculate the cumulative probability distribution. So that's why we need to create another table, that is table 2. So from this we have the category, we have the probability values. So I'll write it here, 0.4, then 0.15, then it will be 0.15, 0.10 and 0.20. Now you have to calculate the cumulative probability. That's very easy. You just have to write the very first values, that is 0.4, and just you have to add this to the next step. So it will be like 0.55, then 0.70, 0.80 and finally 1.00. So the cumulative probability always ends at 1. And so I will just give you this direction. So it's like you have to add this, and then you have to put this value, add this, put this value, add this and put this value. Next you have to determine the random number or the random interval. So this is over. Now setting the random number of intervals, that is also very easy. So interval will always start from one particular range. So in this it always starts from 0. So from 0, 0 you have to keep it, or you have to limit it to one particular range. So that range will give you by this, like the end of this. So it's like 40, 55, 70, 80 and this is 0, 0, so you will consider it as 100. So whenever you need to assign some particular range, you will always reduce a value 1 less than the final value. That is, you will write this as 0, 0 to 39, and so this will be from 40 to 54, this will be from 55 to 1 value less, that is 69, so this will be from 70 to 79, and this will be from 80 to 99. So this is how our probability values as well as the random number, it is cumulative probability and random number we assign. So in this total, like we can see that the dentist clinic is served for 4 hours, and for each patient they require at least 30 minutes appointment. So now we have to determine the number of patients that would be coming. So that from one analysis you can make out that the random numbers they have given, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's possible that 8 number of patients are there from this random number they have given. Else what you can do is, like you can calculate, like for that is 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, and for 4 hours you need how many? So it will be 240 minutes, and for 240 minutes you will be serving each person for 30 minutes. And so it will come out to be 8 patients. And so for like 8 patients you will be serving for this, you will be doing the simulation for 4 hours. It's like the very first person. Now it's mentioned like the arrival time of each patient, or the very first patient, is at 8 a.m. in the morning. So it's like the very first patient will come at 8 a.m. He will service for 30 minutes. So like in the very first, and that is at 8 p.m. patient one will come. Then after that at 8:30 a.m. next person will come. Then at 9 o'clock third person will come, 9:30 fourth patient, then 10 o'clock fifth patient, 10:30 sixth patient, 11 o'clock seventh patient, and finally at 11:30 you will have the 8 patients. So total you have 8 different patients. So this is the mathematical estimation of how you can estimate the number of patients for your simulation. Or you can just see this value, that is random number, and you can just make out that 8 number of persons are there in this. And so we'll construct the third table in this. So that's, I'll just remove this, so I'll require the entire space here to calculate. So that is very easy. You need to have the number of patients here, their category, and then you have to write the random numbers that you have generated from this. So that I will write it as patient number, then you have scheduled arrival time, then you have random number, then you have the category and service time needed. Yeah, so I have this many values, that is arrival time, random number, category and service time. So patient will be 8 patients in total. So I will have 1, 2, 3, then 4, then 5, then 6, then I have 7, then I have 8 finally. So I have total 8 patients after the estimation from this. Now arrival time, like each person will be arriving at what time? So it's like first person will come at 8 a.m. Then after that second person will come at 8:30, then he will come at 9 a.m. So it's like a 30 minute service time is there for each of the patients. So doctor will be, or the dentist will be, serving each of the patient for 30 minutes. Mm-hmm. So it like, then you have 9:30, then you have at 10 a.m., then at 10:30, then at 11 a.m., then at 11:30. So now we have filled the arrival time, like each of the patient will be arriving at these many times. Now the random number that we have given in a serial order, like 40, 82, those values we'll be putting it as it is. No change, no sorting, nothing. We just put those values as it is. So like 40, 82, 11, 34, 25. Then we have 66, 17 and 79. So this is how we put the random number. And then category. So this category, we have to see like this random number falls in which category. So it's like 40 falls within this range, that is 40 to 54, and so it falls in the category of crown. Similarly 82 falls where? So it falls in the checkup. So that we have to write here. Then similarly 11 comes in filling, then 34 comes in filling, then 25 also comes in filling, then 66 comes in cleaning, then 17 comes in filling, and then 79, that is 79 is extracting. Yeah, so this is the category that we have filled. And then the service time, like for crown how many service time it would be requiring, so that you will get from the very first table. So that table I just removed it. So this is the table number 3 we have. So that from the table you can estimate it as for first, that is for crown it requires 60 minutes, and then followed by 15, then you have 45, then 45, then again 45, yeah, then you have 15 and then 45 and 45. So this, from the table 1, you can get to know like each of this category would be requiring how much service time. So this was our table 3. Next, what we do is we construct our final table. So now we have to, so this part is over, now we have to calculate our question. So for that we need another table, so that will have all the service time, arrival rate, idleness and everything. So that will be our final table in construction of this. So we'll have that big table here. So I'll just remove the steps. So our steps are over, just we need for calculation of our final answer, that is for average waiting time and for idleness of the doctor, we need to have to calculate this table. So that table is very easy, so but it will contain a number of columns. So you will have the patient number, so the number of patient, first patient, second patient, the arrival time you will have, then you have the service, that is start time of each of the patient, and then service duration of each of the patient, then service will end at what time, that is service end time, then waiting time in minutes, yeah, and finally you have the idle time of the doctor. So idle time of the doctor, so we just fill this table for 8 different patients and we'll find the values here. So it's like for 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, then 6, then 7, and finally for 8 we have. So we calculate this. So arrival time of each patient, that will be like the very first. So this column, this two columns would be same for this. So it will be like at 8 a.m. first person will come, or first patient will come. So 8:30, then 9, then you have 9:30, then you have 10, then at 10:30 6 patient will come, then at 7 patient it's 11 o'clock, then 11:30 8 patient will come, and service start. So the very first customer would start its service at approximately 8 o'clock, currently 8 o'clock. So let's consider this is an ideal situation where there would be no waiting time for, like from the simulation we have like person starting with at 8 o'clock. Now the service duration from this table that we have, the service time of that particular patient is 60 minutes we have in this. So he takes the complete 1 hour starting from 8 o'clock. So the service will end at 9 o'clock for that particular patient at 9 a.m. So he will start his service at 8 o'clock. He has come at 8 o'clock. He will start his service at 8 o'clock. And so from this table, we estimate the service time, that is 60 minutes. He will be requiring that. Although we have like each patient's arrival time is 30 minutes, but then to its service time, the pain of that person he has to address, and then all those medicines and all those doctor kind of things which they just communicate, that all thing is included in 60 minutes. So from 8 o'clock he will take 60 minutes to complete its entire first patient's appointment. So it's like at 9 o'clock, and then waiting time he didn't have to wait anything, and so idle time that will calculate in the next. So after the service ends at 9 o'clock, the next patient service time will start at 9 o'clock, and so there was a wait here. So it's like the patient waited for approximately 30 minutes here, and so his service is 15, and so he will be served for 9:15. And so the third patient already came at 9 o'clock, but then to the service for second customer ended at 9:15, and so the service would start at 9:15, and so it was 45 minutes, and so it took the entire 10 o'clock. And so if you subtract it, you will get the, that is this service start minus arrival time, you get the waiting time. And then this, that is fourth patient came at 9:30, but then too he had to wait till 10 o'clock, and for fourth patient you have the 45 minutes, and so it was 10:45, and so he had to wait for 30 minutes here, and so this started at 45, that is fifth patient, that is 45. And then again for fifth patient you have 45 minutes, and then he has to, like from 45 you will just bifurcate for completion of 10 o'clock 15 minutes, and then it's like 15 plus 30. So he was to complete at 11:30. So 11:30 his service will end, and then the subtraction from this is 45, then The sixth patient has already come at 10:30, but his service started at 11:30. And then for sixth patient you have 11:15, and so it will be 11:45. And so the difference in this is 1 hour difference will be there. And so 11:45 the seventh patient would come, and then the subtraction, that is the waiting time, would be 45 minutes, and so he will be serving for 45 minutes. And so this was till 12:30, that is 15 minutes to 12, and then 30 minutes for from 12 to 12:30. Next, this patient has already came at 11:30, but then to his service will start at 12:30, and for he will be servicing for 45 minutes. So like 30 plus even more, that is it will be 1:15. At 1:15 this will get over, and this is 60. Yeah, and so in this period of time the doctor was never free, so it was a very hectic day for the doctor to serve all the patients. And so finally we have been asked, we have to calculate the average waiting time. So that is nothing but you have to calculate the summation from this, that is this value comes out to be 285. And so the value is 285 divided by the number of patients, that is you had 8, and so you have the waiting time as 35.625. since it was all given in minutes, we would be unit as in minutes. And idle time, the doctor was never idle, so the average idle time or idle time of the doctor was 0 minutes. So this was how you solve a Monte Carlo simulation problem in simulation modeling. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you found it educated by watching this video, please do like, share, comment, and most importantly, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.